I decided to build a brake light on my helmet which communicates with my electric skateboard. I'm gonna share the log what I've done with you. If you are interested in the principle, please take a look at the previous video first. This was the plan of this project. LED, microcontroller, battery, communication, and case. LED turns on red when the electric skateboard slows down. And LED turns on blue when the electric skateboard speeds up. LED turns on from 1 to 8 LEDs based on the helmet battery status. And next thing is microcontroller. It controls LED and it receives skateboard status and process and check the brake and speed status. It transmits skateboard's data packet to the phone so the Android app can use the packet. The battery has enough capacity, so it should last at least 1 hour. Battery should be light and small enough to be installed on the helmet. Battery needs safety circuit and charging circuit. UART signal should be reached to the helmet. An RF signal should not be interfere the remote controller's signal. So I need to avoid 2.4 GHz frequency. The communication packet from the phone should be carried to the skateboard. The packet should be checked based on checksum. And the case. I'm gonna make a case using 3D printer. I have used NeoPixel many times in my life. Here's some example I have done with NeoPixel. It is cheap and easy to handle, but there's one picky thing to handle. If you use a library from Adafruit, your communication could be interfered by the library because the library literally blocks all the interrupts in order to generate a certain period of frequency. Lately, I heard that there are some solutions to that problem, but at the moment, when I finished, I just used the library and made my code organized so the library could be okay with other communication. Specifically, the interference happened when the microcontroller receives signal data at the same time the LED library is working with LED. Because the library stops all the interrupts, even an interrupt for communication. Anyway, I managed to learn the LEDs. I was kind of happy with that. In the first prototype, I used a strip type of NeoPixel, which I bought from AliExpress. I cut the strip into 4 pieces and soldered by myself. It was painful because it is not easy to solder them together. My soldering machine is getting older and the tip is not good condition at the moment. In the second prototype, I used the NeoPixel feather wing because it is so nice and so compact. The NeoPixel feather wing is meant for Adafruit Feather M0 Bluefruit LE Bluetooth. There's no reason why not to use Adafruit M0 board because it has M0 processor, BLE, and small in size. There are many trial and errors to pick the microcontrollers. First, STM32F401. It is very cheap and decent to use this board. The first prototype uses this board and there was no problem at all to use this board. There's only one problem with the STM32F board. It was too big. I also had to make a room for battery charger and BLE as well. That factors made the case bigger, larger than I expected. There was also another problem with handling NeoPixel because of the blocking code from the library, as I mentioned before. I had to look for another board that has powerful processor and a nice library which doesn't block the main code like Tinzi. One of my colleagues is a big fan of Tinzi. The price is reasonable and very powerful. The only reason why I didn't use the Tinzi is power consumption. It takes 100 milliampere when my program is running. As I am using a very small battery, the power consumption is critical for me. And it also doesn't have a wireless communication nor lithium polymer battery charger. Even if I am using Tinzi, the size wouldn't be smaller. Adafruit Feather M0 Bluetooth LE. It was lucky that I could find this board. It has a battery charger, Bluetooth on the same board. Moreover, there's a NeoFixer Feather wing which could be attached on the Feather board directly. It's simple and easy. The microcontroller itself is powerful enough. There's one thing I have to check whether it has a feature of cutting power when the battery level is extremely low so the battery gets protected. I looked for the Adafruit M0 schematic to see the charging port. It uses an MCP73831 lithium polymer charger. The charger is okay, and I was confused that the charger would protect the battery. But it should be somewhere inside the circuit. The battery is connected with a 3.3 regulator all the time, and the regulator doesn't cut the power automatically. I tested the voltage and it worked with 2.9 volt battery input. It is not good for the lithium polymer batteries. The 3.3 regulator has enable and disable pin to cut the power, but it doesn't work automatically. Something has to pull the pin to ground, but there's no circuit for it. That means I needed to use a PCM integrated lithium polymer battery. Also, I put a switch to cut the power completely. By the way, why do I need to care for the battery so hard? Because I want to make the helmet as small as possible. Compared to a normal alkaline battery, the lithium battery is smaller and more powerful. But it could be dangerous if you handle it in the wrong way. So, I was looking for a battery that is small, which has a PCM protection circuit. I found my old toy drone and took the battery out of it. The capacity was 200 mAh. There were some candidates to use the charger and DC-DC converter for the helmet. One was USB charger. I had this one cell USB charger which uses 18650 battery cell. It worked very well. I used this charger on the first prototype. In the second prototype, I didn't need to care about the charger at all because Adafruit Feather board has the charger. My skateboard has two channel FASC. I can take data from FASC through UART port. One UART port is occupied by a receiver for remote controller. Another port was occupied BLE board to communicate with my phone. I had to take BLE side port. My strategy is to take the UART signal out of skateboard to helmet, and then helmet can relay the signal to BLE, and then BLE could communicate with the phone. So I was looking for a decent way to make the UART communication wireless. I had HC12 RF board. Previously, I used NRF51822 to communicate my skateboard with a phone. It worked very well and handy. I made my running video with data taken by the BLE. But there is one problem if I want to make a brake LED helmet. The NRF51822 BLE board occupies one UART board of VESC. if I want to use the BLE tool on Android, I had to use Adafruit M0 as a hub for communication. Thanks to Adafruit M0 BLE, I don't need to use extra NRF51822 because I programmed and configured the BLE site on the board. I had to make a code for this. The base code that I referred are in the description. This shows the test LEDs within FASC before I printed the case. I tested LED with ring type and strip type. Back then, I had to choose strip type because I had to make the case bigger than now because there were too many components. I am using Fusion 360 from Autodesk for designing. The 3D printer material is PETG transparent 1.75mm. It was packed by all the small components and cables. It was really difficult to fix all the components on the case. The battery was not 200 mAh but 100 mAh back then, which was 5 times larger than now. I attached it on my helmet anyway, and that looked like those pictures and videos. It worked very well. It's bright, responsive, and beautiful. But I somehow got shy because it was too much bright, too big size. I didn't like the size especially. After some research, I decided to use Adafruit Featherboard. It is very tiny and decent. Moreover, it is simple because it has lithium battery charger, Bluetooth LE integrated. With this board, I could take two boards out from my helmet. You can see how it gets smaller than before. I attached the HC12 board on the featherboard directly with four cables. I wanted to make it as smaller as possible. For many regions, I put a switch between plus side cable. The original antenna of H12 was not good enough, so I moved the antenna and directly attached a cable on the board. The length is quite important for the antenna, so I cut the green wire to 17.3 cm long. Also, again, I designed the case for the new components. First time, I made the case to have battery inside of it, but it looked bigger than I expected. I took the battery out of the case and installed on the blank surface inside of the helmet. These are some of failed parts. Some of them were okay, but I didn't like. I threw them away before I took this picture. Anyway, it took long time and energy to finish the second prototype. At last, I made the LED according to my goal. There were many hidden problems to this project that I didn't mention. The most difficult thing was to make the project smaller. It was also difficult to solve because all kinds of problems are connected to each other, affecting and affected each other. Anyway, I built a beautiful brake light successfully. Next project will be the light on the board, which I took away when I upgraded my skateboard last time. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye. 안녕.